Sometimes it's easy for us to get caught up in today, what's only right in front of us. Sometimes we need to just stop and think again. Think about things that are excellent and worthy of praise.
It's cool here. This is where I got to meet a lot of my new friends.
My teacher is really nice, and she lets us do really fun stuff in class while we learn.
Everyone knows it's tough for kids today. We're facing a lot of changes and stuff, and we need to find a way to sort it all out.
Isn't it always the way it goes? Just when you think you've got life figured out, a twist, a big turn, a roadblock. No matter your age, it seems people look for answers their whole life long.
Sometimes we finish a class raising more questions than we've answered, but that's okay.
I feel like it's an atmosphere where I can at least ask about things.
Yesterday is a wrinkle on your forehead. Yesterday is a promise that you've broken. Don't close your eyes.
My graph here, I will now make this 6, and the units on that are radians, because we're not labeled.
A lot of us parents have heard too many stories about trends or school board decisions in our local school district.
Our goal is to provide a line of continuity running through your child's life, home, church, and school working together. It's a great formula, and it's still working.
This is your life. Are you glowing on me? This is your life. Are you glowing on me?
Incomparably great power for us who believe. That power is like the working of his mighty strength, which he exerted in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated Christ at his right hand. And where did he seat Christ at his right hand? Where? In the heavenly realms.
No one has to feel embarrassed or weird about praying here. It's just a natural part of the day.
Come against this vast army.
My scarecrow in a melon patch, their idols.
We're focused as faculty members to be intentional at every turn to create moments of faith building, not to replace home or church, but to complement the faith walk in a large chunk of a child's life.
For a school our size, they do offer a lot. I hear my neighborhood friends
these
talk,
the kind of
and then I can say,
yes.
Yeah, we have that too.
Well, let me ask you something like this.
I have great peace of mind that my kids are safe all day. They're in a setting that I feel I know is protected and free from harm.
Yeah. And even more than that, they are being enticed and encouraged with some pretty progressive material. We're trying hard as parents to keep up with what the kids are learning.
I don't feel like I'm competing with my peers in public school education. There's no need, really. Our whole staff is blessed with all that we have to work with.
Actually, when you take a good look at everything considered for our children's future, how can you measure the value of this?
I realize that my parents have made some sacrifices, and I appreciate it a lot.
We pray about it, we work hard, and just trust God that He'll work it all out for the good.
Christian education, it's a sacrifice for many of our parents. We recognize that. And because of that, we want to provide an education of excellence for our students, certainly in academics, but also in co-curricular, technology, music, athletics, and so on, all very important. But beyond that, it's the Christian values that the students will get in their classes and in their other activities that make Christian education at Southwest Chicago Christian Schools worthwhile.
Before I came here, maybe I thought the kids would act a certain way, or that I wouldn't fit in at all.
It's great to have students say to me, "You remember my dad or my mom?" After a moment or two of thinking, "Yes, I remember. I like to talk to them sometime, and when I talk to them, it delights me that many of the good things they remember from their high school days are still here at CCHS today."
I think I have a good handle on everything the schools have to offer our family, and yet they keep surprising me with new things.
I like it that we can pray in our school, and the Bible stories are fun to learn.
There are a lot of voices out there telling us what's important, telling us how we should live. The main thing is we really want to do the right thing. We want to hear God's voice. Believe me, underneath it all, it's really good to have others on our team. We're all in this together. Think again.